Is owning and operating your own bar a dream come true? Or is it a bit of a nightmare? Stick around and find out.
What'd he say his name was?
Gebatron.
Okay, this game is pretty different from what I normally cover on the channel, but when it came across my emails, it caught my attention. I used to tend bar in my 20s and I enjoyed it, and there was always a little piece of me that thought owning and operating a bar slash brewery would be a lot of fun. I've also been looking for a new game that is simply less stressful than the online tactical shooters I normally play, so I decided to check it out. So what is Brewpub Simulator? A simple explanation would be that it's a game where you own and operate a bar slash brewery where you brew your own beers, tend bar, organize your menus, expand your business, manage staff, react to clientele feedback, and tackle the challenges that arise from all these different factors. So what's the story? Well, I wouldn't say that the story is a strong suit of the game. There is still a narrative here that helps to propel you through the game, and it can give you some focus. The game starts off with you finding out that you have inherited a pub from your grandfather, who also happened to be a bit of a brewmaster. You decide you're going to follow in his footsteps, and first up is, you know, cleaning up the bar a little bit, learning some of the basics of brewing your own beer, and then, of course, opening the bar to the public. There are other things that happen in terms of a story with the game that usually come through emails you receive, such as people will reach out to you for help or with business offers, etc. An early example is that the mayor reaches out, like the mayor of the city, reaches out to you for help with supplying beer for a community event. Then, of course, you get some stuff in return for helping out. So no mind-blowing story here, but there are things that will happen that help focus you towards certain goals. The mechanics of the game are hard to talk about individually because one thing leads to another thing, then that leads to another thing, and so on. So what I'll do is just kind of walk you through how a couple of in-game days actually go. The first step is always brewing your beer, but to brew beer, you need the proper ingredients. These can be purchased via a tablet accessed by hitting the T key. Your tablet is used for many things in the game. Early in the game, you only have one recipe unlocked for an APA, but you'll unlock more as the game progresses. Checking the recipe will let us know what ingredients we need to purchase. Once your supplies are purchased, you can pick them up from a mailbox just outside the front of the bar. Once collected, these items are now in your inventory, which can be viewed by hitting the I key. Okay, so now let's brew some beer. Open your tablet and select the recipe of the beer you wish to make. You can then pin this recipe to the HUD. Begin with water, add your main ingredients, boil, cool, add other ingredients if applicable, then add your yeast, and finally pour the mixture into a bucket for fermentation. Different beers have different fermentation times. Once your beer is brewed, you need to transfer it from your fermentation bucket to a keg. Once in a keg, we can attach it to our tap system via a tube. Now let's go back out to the front and add the beer to our menu. Here we can further edit our beer and set the price. Everything seems to be in order, so now it's time to open up the bar for the night, serve our clients, and make our money. As the night goes on, your bar will get dirty. There will be spills, trash on the floor, etc., so make sure to tidy up periodically. After a few days go by in-game, you'll be allowed to choose your quote-unquote strategy by either labeling your bar a dive bar, a casual bar, or like a high-end bar. Each one of these strategies comes with its own expectations from your clientele. An example being that customers coming into a dive bar won't expect much in terms of cleanliness or beer complexity, but will expect cheap beers. This can be good for you as you won't have to focus on cleaning at all, but you also won't be making as much money per beer. High-end bar customers will expect a clean environment and complex beers, but they will also be willing to pay much higher prices for them. So that's a neat dynamic you get to choose for your bar. After you've served everyone, or perhaps you run out of beer and the night is over, you can close the bar. Now it's time to collect and clean all of your glasses and clean anything from the night before. It's also time to read customer reviews so you know which areas you need to improve on to make your business even better. After all this, it's back to square one, and we can spend money on ingredients to brew more beer, purchase more furniture for the bar, check our emails for any other opportunities, you know, etc. So that's what a standard day or so looks like in the game. At the time of writing this script, I've played the game for about 20 hours, which is longer than, you know, some other games I've played that I've purchased, such as, you know, examples being Wolfenstein, The Old Blood, Mafia Definitive Edition, Samurai Jack, and so on. And I'm nowhere near the end of this game, if there even is a true end. There are more bar expansions ahead. I haven't hired any employees yet. I haven't opened the kitchen yet, held any events, and I've only unlocked 3 or 4 recipes, so I think the game has enough going for it in terms of time sink. Now here's where I should mention that at least 4 of those hours were wasted backtracking and dealing with game-breaking bugs. But that statement comes with a caveat. Those game-breaking bugs, things like, you know, kegs that had beer in it falling through the floor and you losing days worth of work, those bugs are pretty well gone. I've had to rewrite portions of this script a couple times, and that's because developer Star Drifters have dropped multiple patches that have really turned this game around. You'll notice the game is sitting with a mixed review rating on Steam, and that's largely due to how the game performed at and near launch. But like I said, those patches have really improved the game, and I'd bet that if those players were to revisit Brewpub Simulator, their minds would be changed. Now that doesn't mean the game's perfect. There are still some issues like this table that is stuck in my floor, or these customized coasters that take on the background or whatever surface they are sitting on. Every time you play the game, you have to reset your resolution and frame rate. And my least favorite bug is this one where if you put multiple batches of the same kind of beer in a keg, it will not pour properly and you'll end up wasting beer. This is better than this bug used to be. It used to work in such a way where you couldn't even pour the beer at all. You can skirt around this bug, you know, by giving all the beer the same custom name, but we shouldn't have to skirt around it at all. Anyway, so guys, the first script that I was writing, I was not going to recommend this game at all. But my mind has changed, and the devs, Star Drifters, have really turned this game around from a frustrating fail to a fun game that I think you'll enjoy. The game is going for $17.99, you know, US dollars, and I know money is tight now for everyone, so I wouldn't blame you for waiting for a sale, but I do think that there is enough here for you to get $18 worth of fun out of it, especially if they keep improving the game. And as a matter of fact, there was just another new patch that dropped as I'm producing this video. So if that's any indication, I think they will continue to improve the game. The game's hardware requirements are low, so you won't need, you know, a beast of a system to run it. I ran it 4K 60 FPS, no problem, no frames drops, no problems in that regard. If you do decide to purchase Brewpub Simulator, consider purchasing it through my Green Man Gaming link in the video description below. Green Man gets their Steam keys directly from the publishers, so there isn't any extra cost to you. It's just now you'll also be helping support Gebatron Gaming with your purchase. So thank you in advance for that. I'm currently working on a Brewpub tips video. Nothing too deep, but just some things I wish I would have focused on a little more when I first started playing. So subscribe so you don't miss that video, and consider membership if you'd like to get early access to it before anyone else. So yeah, I like Brewpub Simulator. I hope you will too. Please do all the things that help me beat that algorithm. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.